हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्स वेरिएबल्स एंड पार्शियल डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन। सो टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कंटिन्यू अवर चैप्टर नंबर 3, दैट इज कन्फर्मल मैपिंग। सो दिस इज द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। सो टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न अबाउट मोबियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन और अनदर लैंग्वेज इट कॉल्ड एज बाइलिनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। ओके, सो लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज मोबियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। सो द ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन W इज इक्वल टू AZ प्लस B अपॉन CZ प्लस D। ओके, हियर दिस इज प्लस D, वेर A, B, C, D आर कॉम्प्लेक्स और रियल कॉन्स्टेंट सच दैट AD माइनस BC इज नॉट इक्वल टू 0 इज नॉन एज अ मोबियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। एंड समटाइम्स मोबियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इज ऑल्सो नॉन एज अ बाइलिनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। ओके, एंड विद द हेल्प ऑफ क्रॉस रेशियो इक्वेशन वी कैन इजिली फाइंड आउट द मोबियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। ओके, सो द बाइलिनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन प्रिजर्व्स द क्रॉस रेशियो ऑफ 4 पॉइंट्स। द क्रॉस रेशियो ऑफ 4 पॉइंट्स इज अ इनवेरिएंट अंडर अ बाइलिनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन। ओके, सो विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस क्रॉस रेशियो वी कैन इजिली फाइंड आउट द मोबियस ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ 3 पॉइंट ऑफ जेड प्लान एंड 3 पॉइंट ऑफ W प्लान। ओके, सो वॉट इज क्रॉस रेशियो इक्वेशन? सो दैट इज W माइनस W1 इंटू W2 माइनस W3 अपॉन W माइनस W3 इंटू W2 माइनस W1 इज इक्वल टू जेड माइनस Z1 इंटू Z2 माइनस Z3 अपॉन जेड माइनस Z3 इंटू Z2 माइनस Z1। ओके, so by putting the value of W1, W2 and W3 and Z1, Z2 and Z3, we will easily get the transformation which is in the form of AZ plus B upon CZ plus D and which is called Mobius transformation. Okay, so first of all let us understand what is fixed and invariant points. So fixed point is a point Z is equal to X plus IY which maps into itself in the W plan under the transformation W is equal to AZ plus B upon CZ plus D. So by putting W is equal to Z, we will easily get the fixed or invariant points. Okay, so here we have two examples. First one is find the fixed point of the transformation W is equal to 6z minus 9 upon z. Okay, so here put W is equal to z, so we will get z is equal to 6z minus 9 upon z. Okay, so this will become z square is equal to 6z minus 9. So this is nothing but z square minus 6z plus 9 is equal to 0. Okay, so this is z minus 3 whole square is equal to 0. So we have 2 points, that is z is equal to 3 and 3. So these 2 points are fixed point or invariant points. Okay, second is find the invariant point of the transformation W is equal to 1 plus z upon 1 minus z. So again put W is equal to z, so we will get z is equal to 1 plus z upon 1 minus z. So this will become z minus z square is equal to 1 plus z. This both z cancel out, so we can say that z square is equal to minus 1. Okay, so this is nothing but z square is equal to I square, because we can put minus 1 is equal to I square. So z is equal to plus or minus I. This both point are fixed or invariant points. Okay, now next example is find the bilinear transformation which maps the point z is equal to minus 2 0 2 into the point W is equal to 0 I minus I. Okay, so here you can clearly see that here we have 3 point of z, that is z1 is equal to minus 2, z2 is equal to 0 and z3 is equal to 2, and second w1 is equal to 0, w2 is equal to I and w3 is equal to minus I. Okay, so with the help of cross ratio equation, so by cross ratio equation we can easily find out the Mobius transformation. So what is cross ratio equation? So that is W minus W1 into W2 minus W3 upon W minus W3 into W2 minus W1 is equal to z minus z1 into z2 minus z3 upon z minus z3 into z2 minus z1. Okay, now put the value of w1, w2 and w3 here and z1, z2 and z3 here. So this will become w, here w1 that is 0, so w minus 0, w2 that is I, w3 minus I, so this will become plus I upon w minus w3, so that is minus I, so this will become w plus I, w2 that is I and w1 that is 0, so this will become I minus 0. Here also we have z minus z1, so this is minus 2, so this will become z plus 2, z2 that is 0, z3 that is minus 2 upon z minus z3, so this is z minus 2 into z2 minus z1, so this will become 0 plus 2. Okay, so now we have, this is w, this is I plus I, so this will become into 2i upon w plus I into I is equal to, this will become z plus 2 into minus 2 upon z minus 2 into 2. Okay, so here I cancel out and here 2 cancel out, so we will get next term, that is w upon 2w upon w plus I is equal to here minus z plus 2 upon z minus 2. Okay, now by taking cross multiplication, so we will get easily our transformation. So this will become 2w into z minus 2 is equal to minus z plus 2 into w plus I. Okay, so this will become 2wz minus 4w is equal to, by taking negative sign, solving this 2 bracket, so this will become minus zw minus zi minus 2w and minus 2i. Okay, so here we have 2wz and here minus zw, so this will become 3wz. Here we have minus 4w and here we have minus 2w, so by taking it here, so this will become minus 2w is equal to, here we have minus zi minus 2i. By taking w common, so this will become 3z minus 2 is equal, so this will become minus zi minus 2i. So this will become w is equal to minus zi minus 2i upon 3z minus 2, which is in the form of w is equal to az plus v upon cz plus d, where ad minus bc is not equal to 0. So this is our final bilinear transformation. Okay, next is find the bilinear transformation which maps the point z is equal to infinity I 0 into the point w is equal to 0 I infinity. So here you can clearly see that our point z1 is equal to infinity, z2 is equal to I and z3 is equal to 0, w1 is equal to 0, w2 is equal to I and w3 is equal to infinity. Okay, so by cross ratio equation, here we have cross ratio equation, that is w minus w1 into w2 minus w3 upon w minus w3 into w2 minus w1 is equal to z minus z1 into z2 minus z3 upon z minus z3 into z2 minus z1. Okay, so here you can clearly see that our z1 point is infinity and w3 point is infinity. Okay, so by putting directly infinity we will not get answer, so here for that we have to take z1 in denominator. Okay, so here z1 and w3 both in denominator, so here we have w minus w1 and by taking w3 in denominator of w2, here in numerator and denominator also, so this will become w2 upon w3 minus 1 upon, this is also w upon w3 minus 1 into w2 minus w1, and here also by taking z1 in denominator, so this will become z upon z1 minus 1 into z2 minus z3, and this will become z minus z3 into z2 upon z1 minus 1. Okay, now we can say that by taking w3 and z1 in denominator and both are infinitive, so this points will become 0 point, because 1 upon infinitive answer is 0. Okay, and by taking another value, so we will get here w minus w1, that is 0. So this is w minus 0. Here this will become 0 minus 1 upon this one also 0 minus 1 into w2, so that is I minus 0. Okay, here also this will become 0 minus 1 z2, so I z3, so this will become I minus 0 upon this is z minus z3, so this is z minus 0 into 0 minus I. Okay, so we will get next term, that is in numerator this is minus, so we will get in the numerator this one is minus w upon in denominator we will get minus I is equal to here minus I, and here also we will get minus z. So this is nothing but w is equal to minus minus cancel out, minus minus cancel out, so w is equal to I square by z. So we can say that w is equal to minus 1 by z, which is our bilinear transformation. Okay, so this is our final bilinear transformation, az plus v upon cz plus d form, where I z, where AD minus BC is not equal to 0. Okay, so today in this lecture we have studied about what is Mobius transformation, what is cross ratio equation, and how we can find out the Mobius transformation with the help of cross ratio equation, and we have also find out the fixed point or invariant point. Okay, so we can easily find out the Mobius transformation with the help of cross ratio equation, and by using the point z1, z2, z3, w1, w2 and w3, and by using the cross ratio equation we will easily get the Mobius transformation, and also we will get the fixed point. Okay, thank you for watching this video.